The elders who are among you I exhort, I who am a fellow elder and a witness of the sufferings of Christ and also a partaker of the glory that will be revealed, shepherd the flock of God which is among you, serving as a overseers, not by compulsion but willingly, not for dishonest gain but eagerly, nor as being lords over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that does not fade away. Likewise, you younger people, submit yourselves to your elders. Yes, all of you be submissive one to another, and be clothed with humility, for God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all you care upon him, for he cares for you. 1 Peter 5:1-7. Good day you my Lord God, Holy One, Father, Jehovah, hallowed and holy are your names. Thank you for helping me see these words today, and I ask your anointing on them to my own heart and soul today. I want to walk after these words of admonishment and exhorting by Peter. I know they are truth and life to all who find them and walk sincerely in them. I come in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Amen. Lord, as I read these today I realize that in a small way I am an elder, but then so are any of your children who have children and relatives and good friends. We are all, who call ourselves by your name to live lives of humility, of living examples to one another. We are to be salt and light as you have reminded me of a lot lately. I am to walk the walk, not just talk the talk as we say. You have given me in my life some wonderful elders over me that have done great living overseeing over me, who have been simple overseers and lovers of me. It is true that they were great examples of your spirit in love and service to you and your kingdom. I am so happy, rejoicing, to have had those whom you gave me to grow and nurture my life before you. This morning I thank you, Lord God, for their service and help to me. Lord, as a mother, a grandmother, and now great-grandmother, wife, sister, friend and study leader, I see this great commission to me here in these words. You have given me, entrusted me with awesome responsibility and opportunity to serve you and others. I am accountable to you for my life, I am reminded. But you tell me that I am to serve in love, not by compulsion. Not just as duty, but because I care. Because I love others and I love you. And I know that over the years you have helped my love and care of others grow, and my will to do good has grown too. I do know that I do what I do because I care about the eternal life of those I love, not just this temporal journey here. Lord, I ask that you fill my heart with more love for you and others, and that you set my spirit on passionate fire for the saving of the lost. I want to be filled that I may do more good in these last days than I have done. Lord, this morning I am seeing a new way to see the verse, cast your cares on you. Now I see it is not just my own personal cares but my cares about those whom you have entrusted to me as an elder. The ones I am loving and doing any acts of ministering to, be it family or friends. I can and should be interceding in prayer and fasting for many more than I have. Lord, I believe that it does not matter how small I may think what I do is, it is not small to you. Your word told me that even a cup of water given in your name does not lose its reward. So every act of kindness done in a clear heart of love will get its reward. As long as our spirits are honest and not self-centered. I know you know my heart, no matter how I act before others, my heart is what you see and reward. I owe you, Holy Spirit, all the good and the glory for the works you have done in my spirit and the good that has come from your work in me. Praise you. Lord Jesus, in your holy and almighty name I close my morning devotion in your word. Thank you for this time and opportunity to share with you. Thank you so much for this holy Bible and all the truth and helps in it. You have blessed your children with so much good to succeed in this life. Lord Jesus, thank you. Amen.